This is Ertan Teskin from Ozen Engineering, and in this video, I will be demonstrating an EnSight application on plotting a parameter in a rotating component. Let's start with reading the data in the EnSight. So this is going to be a CFX, a transient simulation. From the format options, I will turn the transient geometry on. So here is the geometry and further details. Let me demonstrate some of the features while coloring the components as well as providing some opacity. So as you see, let me run. So as you see, there is actually a tube rotating in the flow domain. So in this particular example, there is also there's the flow actually passing through this cylinder, rotating cylinder, and the rest is a stationary fluid. But the flow through cylinder is pretty much simulated. So you may find this this kind of application helpful or meaningful for certain industries. So we will understand and explore how to create a line passing through this rotating cylinder almost at the center of it and plot certain variables over that. So in order to create a line passing through the cylinder, let me bring the corresponding cylinder and hide the others. So we will work on this. So in order to create a line, we will create actually a clip with the tool selected as line. So when you do that, there is a line actually shown on the screen immediately. So what we have to do is we're going to play with this and position it accordingly so that it's actually inside of the cylinder. So I'm going to have to play with it a bit more. Bring it to the, currently I'm just eyeballing it, right? But I'm bringing it to the, almost to the center of it, as you see. And I will re-extend the line. So that I can move it, drop the cylinder, and then create volume, I mean, create the line, cross-sectioning line accordingly. Need to tune it slightly more. Okay, I think this is good enough. So after positioning the line, depending on where we would like to have, we're going to have to select the part that we'd like to get the clip of it, and then create the clip accordingly. As you see, a new clip is created here. Maybe it's not visible right now, but I will turn off the line tool and Now you can see this cross-sectional line is created in this volume. And this is even more visible. Let me color it. So it's actually this this cross-sectional plane. So it's going to be in this volume, right? So what I want to do from now on, I want to create a plot over this. So highlight the selected clip, right click, and query on line part, right? And I will select a parameter what is better representative for the problem. So let's take the pressure right now. So the pressure along this line is plotted. But this is again a transient simulation, right? So what I want to do is when this cylinder rotates, I would really like to see the change in the profile. And let me bring all the other faces again to the screen so that we can visualize it better. All right, so here is the corresponding line that we drew. So when I rotate it, as you see, the line does not follow the object that we created on. And the plot only appears at the time where the cylinder is actually coming to the point where this clip is created. But we would like to get a continuous profile throughout the time. So for that, we're going to have to follow certain procedure, and I will show you that in the following section of the video. For that purpose, I'm going to have to start from a clean sheet of an EnSight project. So nothing is loaded. So I will load the data again from the beginning, same results file. But on the format, I am not going to select the transient geometry. So by default, it is no. So I'm going to keep it as it is and load all the parts. So it's again read-in. Let me bring the calculation time to the beginning. And again, we're going to follow the same procedure to create a line. So the line is created. Color it so that it's visible. Okay. So again, I will create a plot. Perfect. This is the plot that we would like to have. And from now on, I'm going to add another set of data. It's actually exactly the same set of data, but with the transient option at this time. So remember, I'm going to first create the line and then the plot it with the no transient data. This time, I'm going to keep the currently loaded data, and the case name is going to be case 2. Same data file. Format options. Transient. Yes. And the reason of why I'm doing this is actually for the animation purposes. So I am going to make the similar color adjustments. And you can do however you like, to be honest. But for the simplicity, I pretty much... You can color with the variable too, of course. But for this case, it's going to be just like a single color with some transparency so that we can follow the rotation. Okay. And when I perform the rotation, now you see, as you see this time, the pressure profile is continuous. It's always showing, as opposed to the previous case where it was just like showing when the cylinder was intersecting the created line. So, similar to this one, we can create another plot, but remember what we have to do, again, go back to the previous set, like the case one, to create the plot. I'm going to go to the clip that I created, and another query. For example, this time, I'm going to plot the velocity. And let's make the animation smaller, and I'm going to keep it on the center of the screen. And other plot is going to be similar to the one that we created on the left at this time. I'm going to put this on the right. And when we animate it, even though it's not changing because of the continuous velocity that I provided, but for any property, you can actually perform the scalar transport equation, or you can provide some pulsatile flow conditions, then you can definitely see the impact of that. But the profiles, the plots are always going to show, as opposed to it would intermittently, you know, go black or empty in this case, of course. Let's bring the time component to the screen so we can follow the time while the animation continues. Right. Let's see how it changes, how the time is actually changing. So I'm going to save this as an animation, and we will see how it looks. For that, just to remind you, we're going to go file, export, animation, and the solution time is going to be. Format could be arranged from here, and frame rate could be arranged. If you want to slow it down, you can reduce the frame rate to either half or one third, depending on how you like. So here is the saved animation. So in this video, I demonstrated an EnSight application on plotting a parameter in a rotating component. Thank you for watching.